September 5th, 1972. The world was shocked when 11 Israeli athletes were murdered by Arab terrorists at the Munich Olympics. A radical group called Black September had infiltrated the area where 10,000 athletes were staying. At 5 a.m., the terrorists broke into the Israeli dorm. A coach managed to sound an alarm, allowing 18 team members to escape. But two athletes were shot and 9 were taken hostage. By 9 in the morning, the Olympic Village was surrounded by hundreds of police officers and 24 sharpshooters. At noon, the extremist group announced their demands: the release of 100 Palestinians from Israeli jails and their own safe passage out of West Germany. Negotiations ensued, but Israel would not meet the terrorist demands. The terrorists and their hostages were flown by helicopter to a West German airbase where a plane was waiting. At the airport, German sharpshooters opened fire. The terrorists fired back, and all 9 Israeli hostages were killed, along with 4 of the 7 terrorists and a German police officer. 4 of the victims burned to death when a terrorist threw a grenade and set fire to their helicopter. The games were suspended for a time, but then continued after a memorial service for the victims. The German police received heavy criticism for the lack of security. The Arab terrorist attack on the Israeli athletes on September 5th, 1972 was the darkest day in Olympic history. It was ironic and tragic that an event with the sole purpose of celebrating brotherhood and athletic excellence would be the stage for a bloody terrorist act. Sadly, it showed us how far mankind still had to go to achieve true peace and unity.
Back on the shtick again with Rabbi Shmuli Block. We're more aware now after seeing a bit of video of what happened in 1972 in Munich. And there's now a controversy about trying to have a 1 minute silence at the opening ceremony. What's your opinion on what's going on there?
As far as I understand from what I've read extensively in papers all over the world, that the Mrs. Spitzer, the Andre's wife, he was actually killed in the helicopter. He wasn't killed by the apartment door that I was standing at, which I prayed at. And also went up to that balcony, and I fulfilled my 5-year-old dream, which was to say a prayer on the balcony where the hooded terrorists stood in that same spot and pray for the souls of the dead athletes. So when I left the village, I was ecstatic. I had fulfilled a lifelong dream at 45 from 5 years old, 40 years. Yeah. Anyways, the IOC is refusing to allow a minute of silence. Mrs. Spitzer has been campaigning for this for many years now, through many, many Olympics. And the IOC has always turned it down. Now, people thought that since we're approaching the 40th anniversary of Munich, because it's 1972 and it's 2012, so it's 40 years, then maybe now's the right time that finally the world should acknowledge the terrible tragedy that 11 young guys and old with their trainers came to compete in the Olympic spirit, the spirit of unity, the spirit of peace, where countries from all over the world, Muslim, Jewish, Christian, African,
from all over the world,
get together.
Yeah, that's right.
And all religions.
In the spirit of the Olympic, whatever it is that they believe in.
They believe in unity. That this is a chance. I know during the Cold War, when the United States and Russia were fighting, the United States canceled their team for the Moscow Olympics.
That's right.
And so we do see that there have been instances where politics have come into play with the Olympics over the years.
Yeah.
So why can't the IOC just offer a minute silence at the opening ceremony, 60 seconds, in memory of the 11 lives who were lost? And not only were they lost, they destroyed the 11 lives of their wives and their children and their parents. Parents lost their children, mothers lost their wives, lost their husbands, children lost their dads.
It's a tragedy.
It's a tragedy. Now, why won't the IOC allow for a minute of silence? Well, I'm not going to get into it here because we don't have enough time. But let me end by saying, suffice it to say, that if it was any other country's athletes that were broken into in 1972 and slaughtered like animals, okay, there would have been a minute of silence in 78 Olympics. only 4 years later. But because it was the Israeli athletes, there will not be a minute silence. And that's just the way of the world. Psalm 23, a psalm of David, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you art with me. Your staff and your rod shall comfort me. You have prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup runneth over with blessings. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.
Amen.